Right, here we are. We're starting off in the morning. Very first thing, might as well show you right from the beginning. We've got permission to go towards the country house today, on the estate. Nice and early in the morning, as you can see. I believe the moon is still up there somewhere. Yep, there we go. Just waiting for Ian to come, Mr. MDK01 himself. And we'll take it from there. Just to get this turned around. Right, so we're then at the back of me Landy, in my comfortable little carport. should have done this the other week, but I've had various illnesses like Ebola and leprosy and things. It's a little bit windy, but nothing too bad at all, although the ground is very wet. It's been raining all week here, and it's been quite nasty. But we'll take it the way we find it. We'll see what we can do, and we'll be back later. See you. Right, still waiting for Ian, but it's not too long. But just a little tip. I mean, one of those things that, probably teaching Granny to suck eggs, but what I tend to do is in my jacket, there's always, in these things, several hidden pockets. And in this one here, which is a Jack Pike, there's a side pocket which goes in line with the zip. I always keep a huge wadge of loo roll. I, on about half a dozen occasions now, have been caught short, let's say, and it's not much fun, especially when you've all you've got out there is leaves. But you know, hopefully that's a useful tip. I always carry it. It's always helpful. Whether you know, you might cut yourself, you might need to mop something up, or you might need to go to the loo. There you go. Speak to you later. Right, Ian said he's going to be a little bit late. Got caught up in traffic, bloody motorways. So I got a bit bored. So I whipped out the old Super 10 and got the first kill of the day, which is always good. Speak to you later. And here he is. He turns up. Good man. Now we can start. Speak to you later. Here we have one or two friends. Apparently Ian's not too keen on them. But I'll show you one later that he definitely won't be keen on. Anyway, Ian at the moment is zeroing. He's just getting the old S10 sorted out. Birds all over the place, crows. Bloody, as we came in, saw a squirrel right on the edge of a branch, about bloody 100 foot up. Cheeky little sod. Anyway, we'll be back. Speak to you later. So Ian's zeroing. He's got his new scope. Taking a couple of shots. How's it going, Ian? You can see? Is it okay?
I think so.
Nice one. Do you want me to pop over there and let you know?
Yeah, you
could
do.
Okay, see you in a second. Right, so we're now still in the farm. Got a couple of absolute monster balls. When I say actually monster balls, what I can see here, they are monster balls. But just have a little, he's eating, but oh my god, can he eat. Fantastic looking thing, magnificent animal. Thank you. This is a nice little area, but we're going to be going over to that wood. There's usually plenty of squirrels in that. And I like this one. It's like a comedy Christmas cow with its with his horns. Oh no, he isn't. Oh yes, he is. But right. I'll speak to you later. Oh dear, I love the horns on this one. I think he had a late night on Friday, this one. He's needs to adjust himself. Oh, wow. And Ian's being brave, going over and talking to the moo cows. Oh, they're beautiful animals, though. Absolutely fantastic animals. Maybe except for that one.
Got a 70s perm.
Oh. Yeah, we should call this one Keegan because of his wonderful perm he has on the front of his head. That's yes, Keegan.